literally yesterday somebody said that the Ukrainians paid off the judges or something for the results here, and I'm like, what? Privyet! Welcome to my channel. My name is Wally, and today I wanted to revisit the 1992 European Championships, which I've been, you know, reviewing, reliving. Today we're going to be talking about the floor final. I'm going to do another video about the beam final as well. I thought I would be able to fit them into one video, but it turns out I have a lot more to say than I realized. I don't think I had seen the full finals ever, so I'm kind of experiencing the whole thing for the first time, and I just wanted to talk about it because I thought there were some interesting choices scoring wise. So these were the actual results. I will put them here. So Gina Gojian was first with a 9.925. And the reason that Gina won was primarily because she was the only gymnast to hit. All of her tumbling passes were well landed. She had an adequate level of difficulty. She had good amplitude, good form. Everything was good, except for the choreography. Oh, fix it, Jesus. In the late 70s, Geza Pojar choreographed a couple of routines for Amelia Eberle and Nadia Comaneci that were really universally panned and are still thought to be really bad to this day. And this 92 routine from Gojian is really reminiscent of those routines. It was just horrible. It was like she was in double time for a lot of it. It literally looked like the video was being fast-forwarded. It really didn't do her any justice. And although she was really, really young, in fact, she was underage this year, although she still denies it to this day and insists that she was born in 1977, which the delusion is real. I mean, it's been proved that she was underage. People found her birth certificate. But we would go on to see her do some wonderful floor routines later in her career. So she was definitely capable. And there are maybe a couple seconds here and there where you can see the potential, but this was just a disaster of a routine. That's why I think it's a bit unfortunate that she ended up winning, because nobody else could hit. The silver medal went to Melanie Legros from France. And when I scored this routine, I actually had a four-way tie for first. You know, that is some shades of 2015 uneven bars final. I scored four gymnasts at a 9.9, Gojian, Mitova, Ignatova, and Gutsu. And Legros has really good form on her tumbling. Her tuck double backs in particular had virtually no cowboy. I scored Legros at a 9.85. My issues with her routine were her second tumbling pass. Obviously, she over-rotated, had to put her leg up, and it was on a, you know, pretty innovative tumbling run of three whips to tuck double back, but that's still a deduction. I didn't think her presentation was quite at the top level as some of the other gymnasts, and her dismount, I thought, was relatively weak for an event final. So that's why I didn't have her at a 9.9, but a lot of the judges did, and I can see why she won the silver medal. I don't really have that big of a problem with it. It's not like Kel Skandal or anything. You know, it was a good routine. Tatiana Gutsu had an incredible meet here in Nantes. She medaled on every single event, winning three golds. And I feel like I've been on a crusade for the past 30 years of trying to defend Gutsu and trying to put the respect on her name that she deserves. I think she is tremendously underrated to this day. I think she was a pioneer in so many aspects, and I don't think she's as well regarded as she should be. The fact that it took her until this year to get into the International Gymnastics Hall of Fame still, like, makes me furious. Thank God it finally happened, but I've been bitching about this for years. She should have been in there a decade ago. And even to this day, people are posting fake news about her and her achievements, pretending that she didn't pioneer that split leg double layout, like it wasn't tremendously difficult, and she deserved to get credit for her innovation and her difficulty. You know, her landings in this routine weren't perfect, no, but she had a lot of difficulty. And while her presentation was not the best, it also wasn't the worst. So I don't have a problem with her getting the bronze medal here. In fact, when I took all six of the judges' scores and averaged them, she would have been second. Some people will just say she was overscored. This is a Tatiana Gutsu stan channel, so I won't have it. I won't stand for it. Like, I get heated about it because it's just not fair. It's just like, it's so old and tired at this point. Like, it's literally been 30 years. And I'm excited to hopefully make a video about Barcelona and showing why there's been this untrue narrative for three decades. I don't know, maybe it's irrational, but I always feel a need to protect her because I just feel she's been treated so unfairly. But I also can be critical of her, as you will see when we get to the beam final. The most puzzling aspect of this final was probably Sylvia Mitova. Her scores, they were all over the map. The judges really didn't know what to do with it. There was this dichotomy where she had such a wonderful, expressive, well-choreographed routine. I love her blues for Klook. I did a video a few months ago on my channel about it. It's a gorgeous routine. And she had so much difficulty. Double layout punch front, right into double full punch front, and then dismounting with a tuck double back immediate punch front. The issue where the dichotomy comes in is her form, especially on her punch fronts. The cowboy was severe. There are definitely deductions to be found in this routine. Some of her leaps lacked amplitude as well, so that's why it's difficult to score it, and I think that's why there was a wide range, and I settled on 9.9. When I averaged all the scores, she would have wound up in a tie for bronze with Legros and Lysenko, which I would have been fine with that as well. When I look at the overall final though, I think I would have had her in first if I was ranking the gymnasts. I think she did the best job overall. So the last two routines I thought were the best of the final in terms of just overall floor routines. Tatiana Ignatova. I've said so many times about how a good floor routine starts with the music, and this piece of music is just so beautiful, and it does, you know, maybe 75% of the job for her. But the choreography is also just divine. The part after her mount where she does the little head roll and lifts up her foot. I just think it's just so beautiful. I just love it. Unfortunately, she over-rotated her mount, which just gave the judges carte blanche to knock her down. And I think the judges would have been more than happy to get her on the podium, maybe even give her the gold had she just hit her routine. That also holds true for Tatiana Lysenko, who went up last. They really did save the best for last. That Malaganga is perfection. It's one of the best choreographed routines I've seen in my entire life. It's just exquisite in every possible way, as I also did a video on that routine. Unfortunately for Tanya, she had glaring landing problems on both her mount and her dismount. She almost went out of bounds on her double layout. She had to save it, but it was a noticeable, glaring mistake. And I think the judges might have even been okay with that, but then she landed short on her full end dismount as well. So I had her at a 9.85, but the Italian judge still gave her a 9.95, which just shows you how good of a routine it was. I think they were praying that she would hit because they weren't particularly happy with Gojian being the gold medalist, but Lysenko didn't give them any choice, really, unfortunately. Sadly, that happened to Tatiana so many times throughout her career that she would make mistakes and not capitalize, not hit when it counted. She could have had so much more hardware than she did, and she has quite a bit, so that just shows you what an amazing gymnast she was. So that's all for this video. Please stay tuned for my upcoming part two about beam finals. And if you like this video, please smash that like button, subscribe, comment for engagement, and I will see all of you guys in my next one. Bonjourni. Bye, loves.